Hey, everyone.
Hello.
The warmest.
Oh.
The warmest welcome ever.
The warmest.
Yes.
Like almost too hot.
It's hot.
Get your ears ready, ladies and gentlemen.
I feel musty now.
Ears are sweating.
Things are going to get freaky.
Yeah.
We're going to talk.
Uh-huh.
And that's
about
it.
Yeah, but we're actually big changes today. But before we get to that.
Get to it.
Simon. Ridge Wallets.
Uh-huh.
Yep. They are our sponsor. They have been for a while. We love them. And you know what I keep forgetting to mention?
What?
Guaranteed for life.
Wow.
You know what else is guaranteed for life?
What?
Nothing.
Nothing else? Nothing in the world?
Nothing.
Love
They're
is.
The only company
is,
that does it.
Love is guaranteed.
Love is not guaranteed.
It's guaranteed to pop up, last for, I don't know, a decade, and then go away.
Oh.
That's true. Like
anyway.
Heard about their new features? They have a new feature.
What's that?
They now kill cockroaches.
Oh, yeah. Did you kill a cockroach with yours?
I haven't, but I just heard you can do it now.
Okay. Yeah. Awesome to hear. Hey, guys, go to ridgewallet.com/NeebsGaming. Use coupon code NeebsGaming. You'll get free shipping and 10% off. Once again, guaranteed for life.
And cockroach killer.
Cockroach killer.
They're fantastic. You know who's not a cockroach killer?
Who?
Receptra Naturals.
Well, they should get some.
Tell me more.
I love CBD. You guys know I don't shut up about CBD.
Yes.
Right.
It's true.
Okay. Well, listen, Receptra Naturals pure hemp CBD is made from hemp grown on family-owned farms in Colorado.
Here you go.
So when it comes down to that, the most important thing when buying CBD is the quality, right?
Yeah, you would imagine.
That's why Receptra has third-party testing on all their products, and everyone can access those results online, and you can feel confident you're actually getting what you paid for. So go to www.receptranaturals.com and use Neebs coupon code NEEBS15, and what happens, Neebs?
They get 15% off.
Damn Skippy.
Woo-hoo. All right.
So go check them out. And now, what are we going to do?
On with the show.
When
on
you called on me, I was so nervous. I know. Crap. I felt like I was back in school.
What's going to happen?
You got it. You nailed it.
Good guess.
Man, listen. This may surprise all of you, but I was not good in school.
No.
Oh, no. It doesn't surprise any of us.
No.
Do you have a lot of questions, Neebs?
No. I wanted to not be seen. I wanted to be the quietest, like maybe the teacher wouldn't remember I'm here.
Yeah. You like dress as a plant,
right.
Just stand in the corner.
Whatever you ask me, I'm not going to know it. I guarantee it.
The little kid with like raggedy jeans and bare feet in the corner.
Yeah. Oh, I had patches on my jeans.
Little hillbilly.
Yep.
And look at you now. You play video games on YouTube.
Yeah.
You made it.
That's what I was told to do in boot camp by my girlfriend in high school's dad, who was an Army veteran. He was like, you know, you just kind of under the radar and they won't mess with you. Once they know your name, you're fucked. Right? And sure enough, my senior drill instructor, by the end of boot camp, he didn't remember my name.
That's perfect.
So it was, I did well.
I thought you were going to say like day one, something happened.
Yeah,
like,
no, it actually
you sharted
didn't.
And they found out and then it was just like, Duralius Sharty Pants.
Lieutenant Sharts.
You're done.
Is your name on your shirt?
Yeah. So you kind of like, stamp it with like a. You put it on everything you have.
So they're going to be able to read it and know it.
Yeah, but just as far as like looking at you know, facial recognition is what I'm talking about.
Did I just hear someone short?
Yep.
Smells like Duralius.
I used to sleep a lot in high school, like, and I used to drool a lot at that age. So I'd wake up off the desk, you know, head on the arm with a nice big puddle of drool on the desk quite often.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Hard to hide the sleeping fact when you've got a pond below you.
I fell asleep so much in school.
A little fish.
Exactly.
A little koi pond.
Did you wake up a lot, like 1 inch from your desk? Just your nose just hovering, just barely.
Yeah. Oh, without a doubt.
And you're there's no way they didn't see this.
Yeah.
I'm staring straight at my desk.
Good times.
Well,
you were talking about some sort of a shakeup, Simon.
Well, I mean,
what do you mean?
Well, I have a comment. We were talking. We're going to shake things up,
yep.
Man. And then I said, well, one of my comments I picked before we were going to shake things up was from Neebs Gaming. And it says, why did this video get 91,000 views? And this was on last week's commenting on comments. And it's like, we need to fucking shake things up, do things different.
Right. You have to explain if that's good or bad, though, right?
I think that's bad.
That's a bad number for
Go ahead. Explain that part for me.
Well, I just, you know, people that don't YouTube every day, that they might not keep track of what our goals are for views.
Right.
So a 90,000 view video is not a success for a 1.8 million channel.
Over the course of how long was that? We're at 91.
Oh, like in a week.
Week.
See, that, yeah.
That's the thing.
That's bad for
where
us.
You go like, yeah. And not to say whatever, but you go like, that's our measurement of like, okay, people are into this and
yeah.
Or people are not so
are we
much
pleasing the majority of our audience or
right.
No.
But But obviously, I mean, we're pleasing a lot of people, mm-hmm. and we're hoping that 91. Those people will like, because we're, what do we maybe name this? Commenting on comments is dead,
yeah,
potentially.
That's a nice clickbaity title.
That made me think, but it wouldn't officially be dead, but I was thinking about changing the whole thing, at least with the comment part of it, where each week, one person brings in comments. We'll rotate that. So we'll always be touching base. We love the comments. We love the interaction.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep.
And maybe I'll even do a few. Like we'll do, you know, some.
No, you'll do a few.
Yeah, but we want to talk about other things. But what?
I've got some
issues.
Some headlines that I read in the last 24 hours that were interesting. A couple, actually. One was a lady who died, I think, in Virginia. And she had her Shih Tzu. It was part Shih Tzu. It was like a mutt, but mostly Shih Tzu. Put down.
Oh no!
With her.
How old was the Shih Tzu?
Two. It was the Shih Tzu had no health problems.
Right, but still, was it old?
She just wanted to be buried with it, right?
Yes.
Kill this thing.
That's weird,
isn't it?
Yeah,
that's insane.
You know what? She's in hell, and the Shih Tzu's in heaven right now.
Yeah, exactly.
The Shih Tzu had to go with her to hell.
God, this is really...
The Shih Tzu is definitely in heaven.
What a selfish angle!
I mean, seriously, because you could be the crazy one that just says. When the dog dies.
Yes, of course.
Bury it beside me.
I'll accept that.
Of course. Like that. That's fantastic. There's nothing wrong with that. That's, no. You know, go ahead.
No, when I die, kill the dog too is a little extreme.
Of course.
Yeah, that's dude, taking it.
The dog was healthy.
Step too far.
So what happened with this hole? That's all I got. So what happened?
No, I mean, it happened. It went down that way.
Went down that way. Where was this again?
What country? Be...
I think in Virginia.
Oh, God.
The country of Virginia.
What? Virginia? No.
Virginia.
Virginia did this?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure.
I don't believe
you. Well, you know what? Listen there.
We live in North Carolina.
That's Virginia.
This is Virginia, and in the mountains.
Southern.
I pray that this happened in the mountains, because seriously, that's kind of fucked up. I'm just picturing like a redneck going, she bought it. She bought the dog. She can do whatever the fuck she wants. She wants to kill the dog. Yeah. If I want to kill my dog, I'll kill it.
I ate my dog last year.
It was delicious.
Doglicious.
Tastes like shit. Sue,
I really want to know how old the Shih Tzu was. I mean, it was healthy.
It's like 6 months old.
Was healthy.
Thick should be like, you know, on Joe Rogan's podcast, he's got the one dude, I forget his name all the time, but he's always looking up stuff. Thick, like, is in
Thick,
that position
really
right now.
You should be that guy.
I can do that right now.
Attaboy,
it's like
I love
a double
that.
Threat.
Look
he's
at
like
you.
Talent and background.
I like having Twitter up, our Twitter.
He's usually looking at stuff unrelated. So
yeah, but how does that
good...
help?
That's not true. I always have Twitter up and our email.
See, the truth comes out.
Yeah, but that doesn't help the podcast.
You got to fly
sometimes
in your head.
Sometimes it does. Whenever
sometimes
I bring
it
up,
will. This is going to help a lot more in this case.
Yeah, he's our Jamie. I think
I like
that's
Joe
Rogan.
That's
Jamie.
It. That's it.
I got a man crush on Joe.
Yeah?
Serious.
He's a handsome guy.
I love
he's
Joe Rogan.
Guy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. No, but it has nothing to do with the looks. Like, I don't want to bang him.
It's his skills.
A man crush has nothing to do with the looks.
His talking skills, his interview skills.
Okay, so I just want to hang out with him.
Simon just thinks Joe could take care of him.
Yes. I know he
security.
He could cradle me.
Yeah, the I found the headlines right away. A healthy dog was euthanized so it could be buried with its owner.
God, how old was it, Virginia?
Dog? I'm looking up right now.
Take your time.
Man. And also, we got a fly flying around this office.
No,
I'll catch it. Neve's head,
dude, it's a really good skill of mine.
I got $5 to whoever kills that thing.
No, I'll catch it.
Catch and release.
Once I see it.
Okay.
It's a healthy fly.
No, I'll let it outside. I'll bury it, kill it.
I already really like the new format.
I do too. And the other thing we can fill the gap, another death thing, 102-year-old woman at like a nursing home, a rest home in France, murdered her 92-year-old neighbor.
102-year-old murdered a 92-year-old?
Yeah.
Fuck it, man. That's, if there's a time to kill somebody.
And honestly. Like her care,
yeah. It's worth it.
If you're going to commit murder, you may as well wait the 102.
They're pretty much in prison probably with what's going on there. You know, like you know what? They're like, fuck it. It's going to be the same thing in prison. They're going to give me a room. I'm going to be able to eat whatever. They're going to let me outside.
Right.
And that's if they even make
she
it,
she might
obviously.
Have been senile, obviously,
how does she
too.
Do it?
Well, they found...
Fucked
apparently,
to death.
Apparently a kid... Yeah. It was straight sex. Apparently a carer came up and this 102-year-old said, I killed someone. And then maybe said who, I guess. And they went and they looked in that bed and that person was like, the face was like, had been hit.
Oh, God.
Beaten to death at 102?
Beaten and who knows if there was like some strangulation.
You don't know if this is real.
It is. This
because
was real.
His
we still don't know how old the dog is.
The recollections of the... No, the dog is real, but I'm talking about like the details of it.
Oh, that... No, I remember.
The beating? Okay.
And that was... yeah. Vic, what you got there, buddy?
I'm not finding an age of the dog.
How is that? What a shitty reporting. How is that not the first? Everyone here is right away. They're like, well, how old's the dog?
I just looked at CNN, BBC, and NBC Washington.
If it's a 15, listen to me. If it's a 15-year-old dog that was healthy.
It's still okay, healthy.
Listen, I know, I get it.
Still not right.
Don't tell me it's not a little better.
I mean, it's a touch better.
Yeah, if you're going to murder a dog.
Healthy, but like, it needs to be at least 15, dog.
Like 16. If the dog couldn't get up and eat on his own.
But what if it had arthritis and threw up on the reg?
Well, it's a different story. Right?
Maybe. If it seems like he's in pain.
Yeah. So although, we don't even know.
It said healthy. It said healthy dog.
Fake news. Yeah. Fake news. We don't know what the hell's going on here.
CNN says it's healthy.
It's bullshit.
I want to know how old the fucking dog is.
We don't even know. The dog wasn't probably healthy. This is probably a lie. Not on your end.
No,
like,
no.
I believe that you read it right. Didn't,
okay. I don't know why someone would follow his orders. If someone said, here, kill this dog, I would have said,
yeah, Margaret, I'll kill your dog.
Yeah.
Because the mentality of, if I bought the dog and I took care of the dog and I can kill the dog, that is something, that is,
it's your
tell
property.
Me right now, that fucking most people out there in the country, in the middle of nowhere, they look at animals differently. They'll go out there and they'll shoot an animal
and
if they need to, because whatever.
That's
so if it's their dog, they can probably understand the mentality of like, well, you know what, who am I to tell you what to do with your animal?
Here's the thing. When you got a neighbor who says, I will come shoot you if you shoot your dog, now you got problems.
I don't know why I'm arguing this.
I'm just finding it.
It's a weird side to have to go. It's a weird hill to die on there.
Yeah. I understand.
No, I understand
the
animal
suffering. I understand. I need to eat.
Yeah.
I got to kill this animal.
I'm just saying I understand.
That's it.
I found it curious. That's why I brought it up.
No, it's very curious. Mm-hmm. I still want to know the age of the dog.
I know.
I like the theme.
But, I mean, it doesn't make it any better. I mean, to have to euthanize a dog so it can be buried with you is insane.
I already love the whole just talking about random new shit.
Yeah. No, this is fun.
It's great format.
Because we all have it like
very simple.
It's easy to have an opinion on stuff.
People Absolutely. Do
chat about things.
You want a new topic?
Sure.
Booth or table?
Okay. Booth. Every day. All day.
Right?
I'm all booth.
Day. Oh, yeah. Booth.
Anybody here
booth.
Table?
Table only if you have five or more.
I have one. I don't want to be trapped in the booth. I want to sit second.
Well, you're
in case you have to jump into action, of course.
Yeah, in case I have to.
You're an aisle guy in the plane, too.
I'm an aisle guy on the plane.
You do not like to be on a window. No.
So
a middle.
Booth does, in a lot of cases, unless it's not against a wall.
Can you not?
You're restricted.
Is your body not capable of getting out of a booth if you had to, if you were in the inside?
I don't like bothering other people.
Well, I mean.
But you feel trapped.
Yeah.
Yeah, feel stressed.
But you're not trapped.
I know, but guess
you could stand up in the seat and climb out, right?
You understand that.
It's like
I don't. I'm asking.
I'm telling you.
I didn't know
I feel
if you were
a
like
bit claustrophobic.
A turtle
up in
that's
booth.
On his back or something in a
like,
booth.
Listen to me. If I'm underneath the house and I know I can fit underneath, I used to have to work underneath houses, and I get the floor joists are 6 inches away from.
Oh,
my,
that's very different than
nose.
Sitting in a booth.
But guess what, though? The same mentality is this: when you go like, well, you know, it's not.
You're
whatever.
Comparing like an MRI scan to sitting in a booth.
No, but I'm perfectly safe though. Your mentality is, don't you know? You could. I know I'm perfectly safe.
And what? And like,
it's just the panic in you. It's the
it's
same.
It's not
panic.
Near as enclosed though.
But
you're talking
same,
about. You're talking about if you move 2 inches, you're going to hit your head.
Here
no,
you
but
go,
it's still the same.
Telling
panic.
People they're wrong for how they feel.
I don't like telling people they're wrong.
I don't know why you
I
do
know.
It.
It's okay. We're good.
Probably going to kill your dog next year.
I feel like I could be a table guy. I feel like I've never been to too many restaurants where the chairs are super comfortable. Like I like a booth because a booth is more comfortable.
Yep.
Yeah, that's why I want it.
Exactly. Why don't more restaurants have like really comfortable chairs?
Like Neeb said, the privacy factor is usually a
thing
too.
So what my dad, what my dad's been doing every Friday, I guess him and my mom can't stand this. My mom fucking hates us. They go out with their friends and him and his buddy take a cushion into the restaurant.
Really?
Yeah. You wouldn't think that from my dad, but
no.
But
just to make his ass a little bit more comfortable.
Yeah, because
does it when he's sitting at a booth or a table or both?
No, just at a table.
Just at a table.
Normally there's a group of them, so you can't do a booth.
Gotcha.
But yeah.
So carries the cushion in. It's like a off of another chair or something like that, kind of a cushion.
Yeah,
like it's
yeah.
not an inflatable ring or anything, which
no.
would be less.
See, if I were a restaurant owner. And I had customers coming in bringing...
That's a sign.
It's a sign that I, as a restaurant owner, need to go, I should make my chairs more comfortable.
Well, he's also an old dude
guys.
That's bringing in a cushion. So
yeah,
you just go like,
I mean, you can look at it and go like, maybe he's got hemorrhoids or
hemorrhoid
something
factor,
like that.
Hemorrhoid factor, sure.
Yeah,
but still.
And call him and
joints
ask.
Or
yeah,
whatever.
My dad's got a thing with when we're at the house.
Yeah, call your dad.
He won't let you sit in a chair that doesn't have a cushion on it because he thinks that you're uncomfortable.
Yeah.
So he actually, I'm like, I don't want the fucking cushion.
Okay.
And he's just like, no, like I can get up and then he'll put it down when I walk away just so when I come back there's a cushion.
You need to make sure that your ass feels good there.
Yeah.
There, Simon.
Sorry, I was just related. Not very.
You remember that Sports Illustrated commercial I was in, China?
Oh, do I? He was in a Sports Illustrated commercial,
which I love.
Yeah. I do too. My dad wanted, isn't it interesting that that's what my dad wanted to do? My dad wanted to be an actor. Mm-hmm. And here I am pretending to be an actor.
He hates you. He hates you.
Yeah.
Wakes up every day. Oh. Should have been me. It should have been me.
Yeah, well, we used him in Apocalypse Lane.
Yeah.
He was good.
He was wonderful.
Oh, yeah.
He had more lines than I had.
Yeah. Yeah, in Apocalypse Lane, he sure did.
Me too.
He was a bigger player.
Yeah.
I think he was on Comedy Central as well, Vic.
Oh, he was. He was on twice, actually.
He made it all the way to Comedy Central.
All right. No, well, that was a fun topic.
Yeah. No, so we're done with the booth.
I just think they need more booths. You go to Uncle Louie's, 90% tables. They got like 3 booths.
Booths are expensive.
Still. It's worth it.
Trust me,
they're
the TV that's broken for freaking 3 years. They have literally a 4-inch black stripe going down like a 51-inch.
Oh, my God.
From like a 3 years ago storm.
Like, it's an 8-year-old television, too. Yeah. It's like, for Christ's sake, man.
The new ones cost like $5 these days.
Honestly, that's just more of a fuck you.
Similar
to the customer, you know?
Similar topic on the booth table thing. Like, the wiggly table thing.
Oh.
How do restaurants allow that?
Dude.
How are they okay with it?
It's a battle.
How is it not a law?
I know it's a battle. It should be a law.
You don't even know my life with what... With
wiggle tables?
Yeah, honestly. I worked for the woman who owned Indochine.
What was
right? I had to... They were always being broken. She refused to buy the right... like, it was on her, man. She could have just spent a good amount of money. You just need to... It's for cheap people.
What was your solution to the wiggle table? Like, what given
eat
what you
were...
Eat on
the floor.
Don't say napkin.
No. But you, when you were working for her, she wanted you to fix these tables a little bit? What?
Oh, yeah. The knobs would
What would you do?
Well, they would constantly be falling out because they'd unscrew themselves. So you'd have to put them back
screw
in.
Them back
or
in.
And then they weren't around or they'd run out. You'd have to use these like stick pads to stick underneath there to try to rig it up. And she needed new bases. That's it. What a great show we're having.
No, I mean, we talk about things like climate change and stuff like this, but... We've got a real issue here.
Everybody can relate to this.
How is our president not addressing this?
I don't know. Nobody's talking about it. It's almost like
tables.
A big cover-up of some sort.
Be damn illegal.
I'm done bringing up topics because they're all gold.
When do you want to do comments? Is it like middle show, end of show? Because we all have comments today, right?
I'm going to pull mine up.
Well, maybe this is the last one.
This will be the last one of that format, right?
Sure.
Yeah. But, like, should we do a comment now?
Sure. I think
probably go
right
into
now. I'm just throwing everything. You're running the show today, buddy.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, step right up, folks. There gather around. I'm going to read you some comments.
I'm going to judge how you feel.
Okay. Is anyone wondering how they're feeling? Because I could tell you.
No.
I'm not in a booth.
No, I'm confident on my feelings.
That's nice.
Having a good time.
It's nice to be confident.
Yeah.
It's getting warm out.
I know. I love it.
I don't.
Pool's going to be open. I'm going to be swimming.
I can't wait to go swimming. I love swimming.
Are we in hurricane season again already?
No.
We're not, but there's one already out there. The tropical storm got named. And it's early. Like, this is really early.
Dude.
End of summer. That's hurricane season.
We're screwed. End of times coming now.
It's the name of the podcast now. End of times.
Yeah, coming now.
Yep.
That's it.
All right. I'm going to read a comment from Hector Castro. The video is Snakey Bus, which Simon cut. It's where you drive a bus, and it gets longer and longer and longer, and it's kind of funny and cool.
Yeah.
And it says, do they not know there's a cooldown for the jump? And my answer to that is yes. I knew it. You knew it.
But we weren't hitting jump and then jump again and it not working.
It was just not working.
Yeah, the jump.
We were jumping hardly.
Yeah, there were a ton of these comments. There might have been a time when we tried to jump when the meter wasn't high. But most of the time, it wasn't jumping when the meter was full.
I played that game probably more than anybody because I wanted to unlock a few levels so we had options when we played. There were many instances where I noticed, like, my jump meter is full. I hit space bar, and it just doesn't jump.
So, I cut the video. I never even saw the level. So, there I am.
So, that we expect that, though.
Look at him right there.
Look at it.
Where's that fly?
Everyone but Simon knew.
I didn't know.
This is from Alexander Rain, also from the Snakey Bus video, and it said, thank you for sharing your memory, Neebs. I appreciated it, and it made me laugh. Smiley face.
There you go. It was a good memory to have, but what I liked better was the insult that Thick ended on, and that's why I kept it.
What was that again?
I haven't watched the video yet.
It was just silly because he just said at the end of it, it was just stupid. Nobody wanted to hear the story because Duralius was just like, none of us did. It was just something that just struck us funny. And then you're like, I just wanted to share this story. And then he ended with, you know, it's like, yeah, I don't care about your life, you hillbilly.
I had a fun memory as a child that I wanted to tell y'all during the gameplay. And nobody cared.
Hillbilly stories.
Anyway, watch Snakey Bus if you want to hear the story.
Oh, you kept the story in?
Yeah.
Ugh. Like, honestly, damn, why would you keep this in?
I know.
And then I've got a three combo comment. Because it was all about the same thing. Most of the comments on our Dauntless video were about my voice. My voice is healing. My throat never hurt. I never felt bad.
Yeah, you were scratchy there for
it just, I just had some
like a week.
Yeah, scratchy voice going on. So from Lobomatic, the Shield Master, Peter Van Dijk, and Lindsay Clark, all of them pretty much had comments about, hope your voice is all right, Neebs. One of them actually worded it a little differently. It said, they finally substituted Neebs with another voice actor.
Ah, zing.
But we know what you mean.
Yeah. Is that possible?
That's funny because one of my comments was from Dauntless as well, and it was from Baz Caswell. It says, Neeb's voice went from screaming lady to teenage girl who smokes 20 a day real quick. Why don't you explain what was going on? You had like a funk in your...
It was just like a chest funk. Yeah.
It happens sometimes.
Came out of nowhere, too. Bam.
Anthony, that week have some issues as well, I think.
He got sick.
Yeah, well, I think it's getting warmer, a little bit more pollen in the air, a lot more gunk. A
lot more pollen.
So it's seasonal, unfortunately, I believe.
Yeah, they suck around here. I swear, if I had allergies like some of the people around here, I wouldn't want to live here. I'd be like, no, I got to go move somewhere that's not going to make me miserable for months out of every year.
That's how I was in Minnesota. Until I moved down here, I had horrible allergies up there. It was a really weird thing.
Easy move, isn't it?
It worked for me.
Yeah, like just to go fuck it. Like, yeah, I'm going to live somewhere else.
When you go back to Minnesota, do you still get those same allergies?
No, so it might have just been like, I don't know if I'm not there long enough. I'm usually not there really in the middle of summer.
You think you'd adapt to a place? Like, I've been living in North Carolina now my entire life.
Yeah.
You think my body would just get used to this shit?
They say local honey. I don't know if that's
local
real.
Local honey? Yeah. I think it's real in a lot of ways.
Eat local honey. It's supposed to help you with allergies.
Yeah, start doing that.
And like spin around in circles twice a day. That helps too.
Two times.
Hold your breath and drink water. Hang upside down. Crazy
I do need to try local. I mean, I tried allergy shots and that was just injecting yourself every week with the shit you're allergic to.
Yeah, fuck that.
It sucked. But it did help. I did notice a difference of like, I'm not as stuffy as often as I used to be.
Yeah, try the local honey. Why not?
But I am going to do the local honey.
Yeah, we got derailed, guys. We got.
We did. I mean, you're done with your comments, hey?
Okay.
Yeah.
Who's got some?
I'll just go next because one of mine was very similar to Neeb's, but I took comments from 5 different videos.
Ooh.
Oh, wow.
This is the first,
crazy.
I believe. This is the first.
Insane.
Wow. It's going to be fun to cut from video to video to video.
I'm sorry.
You don't have to, Simon. I've never thought about that.
Yeah. It's Cleet commented on our most recent Conan video and said, did I hear a genuine giggle come from Neebs?
They're up
and
there.
And in quotes, you don't know how. Do you remember that moment?
Which video was it?
This from Conan, where you're like trying to figure something out and Simon's like...
Simon starts doing a voice.
You get tickled
by his voice.
Oh, and you give me shit and, you don't know how.
Just hit a button.
You know, like you were being a butthole and telling me about, you know, how you still don't know how the game works. You don't know how. But you know what? You don't know how. You don't know how it works. Huh?
I love that voice. How come you've never done that before?
Oh, because it's a new voice.
All the cartoons we've done, we could have used it.
Yeah, but I lose it. I lose it. I lose it. I already lost it. It's gone.
You've already lost it.
It's gone.
All right.
You don't know how. And you're like, where'd that? How come you've never used that voice before? It's a new voice.
All the crappy voices he's been doing, and now he's got a good one.
I do the best voices.
If Neebs has a genuine giggle in any video I cut, I usually up the gain about 6 above every other thing.
An angel gets his wings.
I really enhance it. It has to be there.
The giggles are the things best. Tickle me, but I don't laugh a lot of times because...
And I don't stop laughing.
We've been doing comedy so long. We used to do so many scenes where you tried not to laugh. I think...
I've trained myself
to not laugh out loud sometimes. Right.
You've trained yourself to be dead inside.
Yeah.
Oh. Duralius
sees the fly.
He stood up and he's after the fly.
Bear calls them sky raisins.
bear doesn't talk.
Oh, he's right there. He's, oh, God.
He says,
my face.
Oh, he's right on your head. He's right. Oh, he's. Oh, my God. It just landed in your eye.
Oh, it's going to be like.
Oh, it's on your nose.
Oh, oh, God. Yes.
Duralis is going to slap Neebs right now.
Oh, it's on Duralis. Hit him.
He's on your belly, Duralis.
You can't hit him.
Tummy drums. Go.
He went around you. He went to the butt side.
Right, let's, son of I a thought bitch. I was getting all ready right. to get open-handed right. in the ear.
A wily one.
That, but no. that had intense nice music ringing? To it, so that's going to help
okay,
it a little bit.
Good.
Yeah, a little tension.
Yeah. Yeah.
I had my mouth baby. Closed. I had my eyes shut. I was waiting to be smacked in the face.
Yeah.
Your cheeks were puffed out.
Yep. Yeah. For protection. I to understand. Soften the blow.
Right, yeah. Just prepare your face.
Airbags.
He's on your can. He's on the backside of your camera.
All right. All right.
Let's move on. Go ahead.
Next comments from Morgan Carr. This is from Commenting on Comments. Scrolling through my Facebook feed for the last few weeks, I kept seeing ads to buy $4,000 3D printers. Get one free. Amazing deal. And I couldn't figure out why. Then it suddenly dawned on me that yesterday I'd recently watched a YouTube video that mentioned 3D printing over 100 times. Thanks, Neebs Gaming, for screwing up Google's algorithm and making me laugh when I wasn't even watching one of your videos. 3D printing.
Nice.
That's what he said.
Wow.
Yeah. So there goes everybody's algorithm.
That's fun.
How'd that go?
I don't think there was any result. So whatever Ada Hop was talking about was crazy talk.
Maybe the day that he had a video come out, it was National 3D Printer Day.
Could be
a thing. Mr. Taco 89 on our recent ARC video says, use the owl to dive straight down into the ground near enemies. It causes an ice explosion that does minimal damage, but reduces all nearby enemy movement speed by like 80%.
Ooh.
Pair that with the reach of the mech, and you can back away while attacking just about anything and be just fine.
Y'all haven't tried that, have
done
you?
That by accident before. How?
I don't know. We should try that next time.
And well, it doesn't freeze the owl?
Dive bomb.
Sounds like a pro tip.
I've never flown an owl in that game.
Huh.
Yeah, I mean, operating is kind of like a griffin. You just point straight down, you dive.
Yeah.
But, okay, so you just dive towards the ground, land on the ground, ice explosion, freeze things, smack it with a mech.
To see
I'm looking
that.
Forward
we'll
to
try
trying that.
Yeah,
it'd be
we'll try
great
that.
If it didn't freeze the owl as well like it does when you do it manually. You know,
it might not.
You get frozen along with whatever you freeze around you, and it heals everything around you.
Yeah,
so.
That's just the free. I think the dive bomb.
Yeah.
I'd does hope something else. Different. I don't know.
We'll try it out. We'll science.
Yeah.
Sure.
On my last comment comes from Dimples McGee on the I'm on a Boat cover. Says, still waiting on that where everybody knows your name cover.
Oh.
And says, making your way in the world today
takes everything you've got.
And guess what, Dimples McGee? That's coming soon.
Ooh.
Within the next
tease.
2 weeks from Ooh. When this is being recorded.
Tease.
But will it be a rap or diddly diddly?
No, it won't be a diddly diddly. It won't be a rap. Brr, 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 brr. It's going to be the most abrasive thing you'll ever hear.
That's
no,
technically
that's
a diddly diddly, though.
That's not it? A diddly diddly. You don't know the difference. I expect this from the layman, you know.
Oh. The layman?
The layman. Isn't that what you call it? The person that's not smart?
Layman?
Layman?
Layman.
Wow. Your average
the
Joe.
Layman. Yeah. The layman.
The fact that you
if that's your insult, you're probably
them.
In that category.
I too am a layman. Welcome to the club.
Hey,
hello.
We should go take our cushions and go grab a sandwich and a beer somewhere.
Somewhere with a nice booth.
The layman.
I know okay. A dude whose last name is Layman. I wonder if he's heard that his whole life.
Yeah, layman's terms. Mm-hmm. It's simple, right?
Yeah.
What about Hyman's
simple,
terms?
Simple man's terms.
Hyman's ketchup.
Oh.
Never mind.
Okay.
All right, I'm done.
Whoa.
Oh.
I got... Ooh.
Oh, Astro's ready. Go ahead,
Astro's Astro. Ready.
Ooh, I got some. Most of mine are from Sea of Thieves. This one's from Jort Wagner. Jort is a funny name. But okay. Says, I know it's only four players, but I miss Duralius. And yes, we miss him too. But I think we're going to do the same thing. Well, not at the same thing as the forest, but we're going to cycle Duralius in and out. Because it is a shame Sea of Thieves is only four player.
Hmm.
But,
oh, yeah, no, rotation needs to happen.
We'll rotate Duralius in.
Okay.
They need a five-man ship.
They really do, yeah.
Man, that'd be great.
That would be perfect.
That'd be perfect. But, yeah, unfortunately, it is only four players. But, yeah, Duralius, we're going to get you into the scene.
Okay, I'm still here.
Killer Shadow says, can you do more episodes of this? And don't skip the traveling. We are going to do more episodes. First one did great. And, yeah, skipping the traveling just kind of comes down to what happens during the traveling. With the first one... Not a lot happened during the traveling, so I cut a lot of the traveling.
As you should.
Yeah.
Because if we're not talking,
yeah.
And we're just traveling.
Yeah, exactly. Well, a lot of the times, like, I was editing in my brain as we were playing. So it's like, you know, oh, we need to go to this island. Let's go. And then it's like, okay, I'm going to cut to the next island. So we don't need to say anything. We just need to travel there.
It also makes your week a little easier, so you don't have to go through the next 15 minutes of footage.
Yeah.
You can just skip ahead to the action.
But in the one coming up, I use a little bit more traveling because it's kind of fun because I think we do a lot of training Simon how to operate the boat, and it's kind of fun to see.
Right. Yeah, I'm sure it's fun. So happy to be here.
Viram says, big ship to begin with for a series. Oh, wait, it's a sponsored promotional adventure for Sea of Thieves, isn't it? No other episodes? No, you don't buy a big ship to begin with. If you have four players, you just get a big ship.
Yeah. There's three ships to choose from
when
you log in.
If you have one or two players, you get a sloop, it's a smaller ship. If you have three players, you have a brigantine, I believe it's called. And then if you have four players, it gives you a galleon.
Yeah, so, that episode was sponsored by Shark Sushi.
Yeah. Mm. Oh, talking about another good moment of Neeb's giggle.
Yeah.
That's why I use it right at the front, because Neeb got tickled of just puking from eating the sushi and then puking on Simon.
Good food.
Mm. Yeah, I just had like shark sushi and a coconut with some banana.
Oh, God. Crap. You just threw up all over me.
I did not. I thought it was good.
Jeez, man. Your face looks green, dude.
Well, I just threw up shark and banana, didn't I?
Yeah, my God, you look like hell. Oh, God!
They caught me by surprise.
Yeah, you have a genuine chuckle there.
What's the big ship, the Galleon?
Yes.
Can you pick that as a single player?
I don't think so.
It's not very a good idea to do
well,
that.
Well, no, it wouldn't be a good idea. I think you can pick it, and theoretically you could, but it's a dumb idea. You know, you don't want to try to operate a ship that size with one guy.
Yeah.
Because there's so many sails to turn, so many things to do, it's just a bad idea. My last comment is from Salty Hellregal that says, I need me a crew on the Xbox for selling alone on these seas. Be a bigger pain in the arse than playing Dark Souls while blind on grog. If ye be on their Discord server, ping so I can ping you me on Xbox.
Yeah?
Anyway, Salty Hellregal wants some players to play with, so if anybody's out there on Xbox, or that's cross-platform,
it's
you
PC
can play on
Xbox.
PC and Xbox, you can play together. Hit up Salty Hell Regal.
Damn right.
He needs
Come
a crew.
On now. Come
he needs
on.
A crew, damn
he
it.
He does, man. Yeah. It's a good place to ask.
It is a good place to ask. I see that. I want to help him out. I want to get him a crew.
Very cool.
Somebody out there crew up with that man.
We should do a classified section in the middle of our podcast.
Honestly, I'm talking about we could be adding that to a few of the comments, trying to pick, you know, it's a good conversation
classifieds,
starter.
Classifieds, yeah.
That reminds me. Yeah, it just reminds me of when I used to work at the news station, and I was in charge of doing, like, the Sunday morning announcements that have to go up during the show, and they were always just so terrible. Because, because it was all the stuff in town that was going on that you just didn't give a shit about.
Right.
It's like, down at the community center, we're putting on a children's play. It's going to be at 6 o'clock.
At the battleship,
Italian heritage dinner Thursday night.
The frog racing contest at the battleship.
Just all kinds of stuff where you're like, oh, man. What the hell?
Yeah.
Local I was news. Flipping through the other day, and I saw they have the community announcements, whatever, and they were talking about it was a heavy day on pet waste. So it was like, you know, all the health problems with leaving pets waste around in a city, you know, because there's a lot of people here.
Yeah.
Where the drain off and the diseases and the water.
Right.
And then I did not know there was a $250 fine if you don't have a plastic bag with you.
Hmm.
That's what they were saying. Like, you got to have the bag with you when you're walking your dog.
No. All you need to do is have shit on your hand as proof that you pick it up with your hands.
You could argue that, couldn't you?
Yeah.
I carry mine with my hand.
Yeah. I don't
Are you
like
even
plastic,
a man?
I think
I
you can fight
officer?
That.
Yeah. I don't waste paper either.
Yeah. I don't believe in plastic for one.
Yeah. And I also like the feel of my dog's shit in my hand. I love the way it's squeezes
But I'm really, you
could
have like a solo, you could have like a solo cup.
Well,
anything.
If you had something, but if...
Yeah, well,
if,
I guess that's still plastic.
If they stop you and you're empty-handed...
Simon, you used to put it back in your dog, didn't you?
Well, sometimes.
Just stuff it back in.
I would love to see
if
that
it didn't
moment.
Shit
when I say
if
you shit.
Look done. If it was wet, I'd try to get it back in to get it hard again.
I would love to see that moment where the cop goes, so I see you're walking your dog. Do you have a bag? And you're like, no, I use my hand. And just luckily at that moment,
Your dog shits.
Your dog just goes number two.
Yeah, I'd have no problem picking up my dog shit.
I know, yeah, over a $250 ticket, I'm sure.
Of course.
Put it in your pocket.
Yeah, where do you put it in my pocket?
Day,
oh,
officer.
Man, I ruin my jeans all the time, officer. Don't even tell me it's a bad idea. I just love doing it.
And then offer to shake his hand.
Yeah, that's luckily it. I have cargo shorts on.
But there is a special place in hell for people that don't pick up their dog shit. Let's go ahead and get that out.
I agree.
Oh, yeah.
I agree.
Absolutely.
Come on.
Like, in the country, it's not a big deal.
It doesn't matter.
No, it isn't a big deal.
In a city, it becomes a problem.
Yeah.
Of course.
Ooh. Is it the state of Washington? Human compost now is legal?
It's legal now, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I know they had cemeteries out there which weren't embalmed and weren't casketed.
Right. Okay.
They just had places for years where you could just be buried in the ground. But right. That's also an issue.
I'm talking about human feces.
So what are you talking
what
about
you
with
saying?
The feces?
Human composting.
Yes.
So what? Tell me
for
why.
For bodies, for turds.
Mm-mm.
What is it?
Oh, no, I don't have the details on that one.
Well, I don't know. Like, honestly, I just know that people will take, compost is what you use to fertilize the earth, right?
Right.
So
but human.
Human feces. Well, of course, why not?
But it's not, I guess it's not legal.
Well, why?
Oh, I don't know.
Disease,
this was like a
probably.
Deal. This
no,
like,
but I mean, if you're turning it into what it's supposed to be turned into.
It's probably just because people get wigged out by it.
Probably because it's not done properly.
Okay.
Most of the
time. I don't know anything about it. I should shut up.
I think you have to cook it into something called cake, oddly enough.
Really?
Turd cake, yeah.
So what you're saying now you think...
Washington State, you can now compost. First state ever to allow human composting, Washington.
Yeah, why not? That's what I was saying, but then they're explaining the things of, I don't know.
Yeah,
as long as you're doing it right, you got to have regulations just like anything else, right?
This is in the last couple of days. I'm always up to date with this shit.
Did I hear Washington was going to try their own state health care?
Oh, I don't know.
It was one of those northwestern states.
Well, that'd be cool, too,
give
right?
Give it a shot.
Go test
It'd
shit.
It'd be a great experiment, wouldn't it?
Well, that's the idea. I
science,
mean, that's why a lot of people are for states' rights. And it's like every state can kind of run their own experiment, which is a great idea.
Could you imagine if just one of these states that like hardly anyone's at, right? Like Washington's pretty freaking big. It's pretty spread out. There's a shit ton of country in Washington. Like, and then all of a sudden they've got the shit when it comes down to healthcare. Like, it'd be interesting to see the flood of people that just be like, yeah.
Go in there.
Let's go.
But it is. I just read it. It is mostly about... human bodies composting.
Interesting.
So, who's going next? Simon, it's between you and me.
Fight.
Fight.
I don't want to fight.
I don't want to fight either.
Yes. Fuck.
And chances are, God. I'd rather not fuck either.
Yeah, let's not do either of those.
Fight, fuck.
Fight, fuck.
Just choose. Do you want
to? I'm trying to get my
turn on.
Then
I'm going.
All right.
You can't turn that on.
Let's can't wait.
Now, I feel like it's been a while, and I know this is way back, but... that scrap action film thing I did, if I read any comments from that, and if I did, I forgot, because we had PLGX in between, like I kind of lost track of videos, but I went back and I looked at a couple comments, and I know I didn't read these, so it's whatever. So I've got three from that, and then I've got two from something else.
And then what?
Anyway, which one?
Hmm?
What's that?
Oh, I just liked how you were going to give us your whole day. Before you did it.
Well, have you ever heard any of your stories?
Oh, Lord.
Yes. Actually, I was telling one the other day about me and my
uncle. This is from Von Chua. Finally, the entire effing crew. About damn time all of you guys be in a single video. Now, if only this can happen more often. Ark, ahem, clears throat. Ark. Seriously, though, I miss the mute member of the tribe and the goddess of Conan. Could be a great addition too. So I was just pointing that out because, yes, that was officially probably the first video that had all seven of us in it.
Yep.
And I took the risk, and man, did I regret it. No, right. I didn't, but it, like the behind the scenes, you know, it was just it was a lot. It
ended up being a 5-hour recording.
It was a lot.
Yeah, that was a crazy recording.
It was a long one. I'm proud of the finished product, though.
It was fun.
The movie. It's top notch. Tuesday's Child said... Slightly disappointed you didn't name the movie That's the Courage. Oh, well, maybe you can save it for the sequel. I was like, that's a fun thing to hear again. Mm-hmm. Anthony's famous That's the Courage.
Yeah.
Yep. I forget even what he said that in or why. It was a scrap, I'd imagine.
It was a scrap. Yeah, that's the courage.
It was one of the dumbest things I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah.
I was happy to hear it again.
That's the courage.
Love you, Anthony. Third comment from that video is from Why Though? And the question was, why was that good?
Why was that
good?
Does
that mean they liked it and didn't know why they liked it?
I have no idea.
Or they didn't understand why anybody else would like it?
Hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, I thought it was So we'll just leave that at that. Okay, and this, I think these are both from, I guess, the PLGX video.
Okay.
That Ada cut that week. This is a conflicting comment.
One's different than the other.
I like these conflicting, or this one in particular. Or both of these, rather, the combo. Big Boy Bluey said, "We already know what you look like, but it's weird seeing your faces on your own channel."
I like how you said it with a certain tone.
That's how I felt it.
You made him sound like a jerk the way you read it.
And then, in contrast to that, Low IQ Plays says, "I thought Duralius was black." Right below it.
Yeah.
It was so perfect.
Yeah.
We already knew.
It's like, wait.
He's white.
And then to top it off, I just thought it was funny to read, and someone really likes Thick. Sive DeVenice says, "I thought I remembered Thick being ugly, but I guess that's just his heart."
No, I am ugly on the outside too. So just to clear,
it sounds like they thought that. Oh, what a handsome
yeah, I know, tiger
fellow.
I think the camera does things. It's smoke and mirrors.
Well, it shows your face.
Yeah,
you're very cute.
Thank you.
Adorable little dumpling. That's it for me.
All right.
Now it's Simon.
What will he bring to the table?
A couple of old. Things like you had a reminiscent thing.
You used to
give
me shit about picking old ones.
No.
I have to go back.
Yeah, you did.
No. Well, you got to let me finish, douchebag. All right, so.
It's another new good voice.
I like that voice.
Douchebag. No, they're not old. They're not old comments, but they're comments commenting about things that are old. So, like, for instance.
I got you.
Right. It's like one would be day 583, still no Lion King review.
Shit.
The others gave up, but we stay strong. That's the Iron Maverick. I mean, the fact that it's been a while since I've seen it. Like, fucking A, man.
583.
Still running, huh?
Rock on.
That's over a year.
Easily.
Yep.
It's quite a bit over a year.
Yeah. Duff said, "You should do drunken bar fight."
What?
Drunk. We didn't do it drunk, but...
Do drunken bar fight drunk.
Yeah, that's what he's saying, to do it drunk.
Yeah. Ooh.
I know. That. But really, honestly, I would have collapsed with exhaustion.
Yeah, you were like...
I was way out of breath.
We played it today.
And
one round, Simon forgot to breathe.
Oh, yeah. It was...
Just held his breath throwing punches for like 15 minutes.
Yeah. No, it was all right.
Well, I got to play it for the first time.
What'd you think?
Loved it. Yeah. It's fun. I don't know how to beat it.
Yeah, no, we can't.
I have no idea, but it's still fun.
Thick, you did not feel hardly at all sick, which is
pretty
cool for you, I'm assuming.
That was great.
It was disappointing for me.
Yeah, no, I was happy that game didn't get me nauseous. I felt just a little bit towards the end, but not much at all, and it made me feel better about VR. And I guess there's one coming out, the new Vive.
The Vive has another one coming out. Oculus has another one coming out.
Valve has.
Oh,
Valve
yeah, that's right.
The Index.
Yeah, God, there's three of them.
There's some options there, and I heard, less likely to get motion sickness.
Well, I believe the displays on the eyes, they have a higher hertz rate.
Yeah.
Like by 90 to 120.
It hurts more.
From what Anthony said.
Do they have any kind of VR headset where one of your buttons is a quick check your surroundings button?
Well, they've got the camera on the front of the Vive.
Yeah, where you could hit it and it would just kind of opacity come through.
It should be such an easy thing.
You're giving away billion-dollar ideas.
No, but the idea is...
Anthony has it? Yeah. So you can see through the camera?
Yeah.
Okay, that's
the
thing.
But is it easy to do now?
Yeah, you just double-tap
the
button.
Okay, because in the beginning it was not that easy.
There you go.
Yeah, I love it.
It should be always easy.
Smart. I'm going to say I invented that because
I didn't
know about it.
Just got to grab your beer.
Jojo Boy 156 says, "Remember cat milk?"
Mm-hmm.
And I thought that reminded me of something, and I thought it was old school, and I was hoping one of you would remember what it was from.
I don't remember.
I remember vaguely.
I remember saying it. That's all.
I don't.
That's it. Nobody
remember us laughing about it being a thing.
All right.
Was it a stream thing or was it a video thing?
Good question.
That'd be a fun nickname for someone.
What's up, cat milk?
My boy cat milk over there makes the best brownies.
Nobody has an excuse or a
good
reason
name for
why.
A doctor.
Dr. Cat milk.
Cat milk.
Dr. Cat milk will see you shortly.
I'm sorry, who?
Always comes in with
just
a bowl
get undressed
of cat
and
milk.
Sit on the table.
Yeah, your butt straight up in the air.
All right, so no, we don't remember it right now. Sinsan says, "Here in Colorado, we have an event called Zombie Crawl every year at the Outdoor Mall in Denver. there should totally be a Neves crawl. I thought that was...
We have a zombie crawl in Wilmington. That's a pretty common thing.
Is it really? Mm-hmm. Okay, so you guys...
Zombie crawls are around.
Just like a zombie and drink beer?
Yeah.
Just go from bar to bar?
Yeah.
Okay.
They're a pretty big deal. Eh. Especially around October, of course.
I don't know. I wonder if that's a fetish. I'm sure it is, right? Like two zombies dressing up, like, you know, male, female, male, male, whatever, anybody, and just going to town.
That'd be the last thing I want to dress up like it. I'd rather dress like something else.
Yeah, but I mean, why is that more appealing or less appealing than dressing up like a fox or dressing up like a clown and banging?
A furry?
Like,
I don't know.
It's all the same thing, right? It's just dress up. So why is a clown better than a
zombie? Well, I think furries, they really enjoy like the soft features of each other, and I think a zombie doesn't bring that to the table.
But furries are also not a sex thing.
It's down to the person.
It's down to the person. But anyway.
For some people, it's just comfort, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah,
it is.
Social anxiety.
They might get a little bunny fucking on, you know? Mm-hmm.
But your personal preference is to not bang dressed up as a zombie, banging another zombie.
I think if I dress up like a zombie, it's going
to
be mostly messy. It's going to be like
a lot of makeup,
wet blood and stuff that's going to get all over everything.
Yeah.
Like there for a while when I was picking my Halloween costumes after many years of like being uncomfortable, I'm going for fun and comfortable this year.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I've made some bad decisions.
That's the way to go. All right, well, I'm done. It's a wrap on Simon.
Good job. That's a wrap on all of us with comments.
Mm-hmm. What? We could talk about what other stuff I missed the news stuff in the beginning. The fun stories.
Yeah.
I don't got shit. Next time we'll prepare, maybe.
Watch that Terminator trailer.
Ugh.
Which, yeah, that's kind of my reaction, too.
It's just meh.
And I like Terminator. Like, I like that. I mean, the first two are great.
Linda Hamilton looked like Willem Dafoe.
Yeah, there were a couple of shots. Like, oh, Willem's in this.
Yeah.
Now,
I'll get you, Spider-Man.
Arnold's in it.
Yeah.
It looked like Arnold in there. Well, and then you said... Oh, Thick said something when we were watching the trailer. He said somebody kicked Arnold in the back.
I saw.
What is that? I didn't hear about that.
Oh, you didn't see it?
What was it, in Germany?
I thought it was in like Africa.
South Africa.
Yeah.
It was somewhere, but it looked like he was in an auditorium or something like that.
Yeah.
And he was just like interacting with the crowd. Looked like he was just, you know, signing pictures. Some guy just runs up and does like a jump kick.
Both legs out.
Like a drop kick.
Into the
bottom of his back, like his lower back-ish.
Okay.
He only went forward a couple steps. I think maybe the people in front of him might have, you know, prevented him from going further, but he just looked confused and looked around, and there was a security guard, or like a bodyguard went down on that, or like got that guy real quick. Yeah, they
got him out of there.
It didn't like
Arnold for some reason.
No, he was shouting something weird. I don't know what it was. I heard Joe Rogan talking about it.
Yeah.
So he said that, and they watched the footage during the, you know, their podcast, and Joe, my buddy, my man crush Joe, he does a lot of fighting. So he looked at the kick too. He's like, oh, that guy didn't even know what the fuck he was doing kicking. So apparently the guy just jumped and then put his legs out pretty much. Didn't have
probably
any real
force
behind it.
Probably his first drop kick he's ever done.
Yeah. Right. Didn't even actually do it right.
Like
what was the
goal of that? In the, you know,
he was screaming something weird and shitty.
Pay-per-view match with him in a cage.
Yeah, you could look that up. Yeah. I bet you find he was yelling something.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know.
It seemed like he had some mental issues going on for sure.
Right.
Yeah, the crazy thing about Arnold, he's my height.
He's a short dude. Not that you're short, Thick.
I would say he's average. But
no, I'm surprised he's actually that tall, because there's a lot of big people out there in the movies, obviously.
Like Stallone?
Yeah, Stallone's like 5'6".
Yeah, we passed him. You guys didn't even see him. We passed him at Santa Monica at the
Probably
pier.
Wasn't even him. Who knows?
I'm pretty certain it was him.
Yeah, but I would, because, you know, when you look at people in the movie, you just assume they're kind of big.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but
I would expect Arnold to be... fairly tall, but yeah.
Me too. I mean, obviously, camera work makes him look bigger. Shoes, like Patrick Swayze, I've met when I worked in publicity, and super nice guy, but I expected him to be tall, and he was not.
Short little guy.
Yeah.
So my first experience with Joe Rogan, did you guys watch News Radio? Was it Talk Radio?
Yeah.
He was in that. That was one of my favorite shows.
He was like the maintenance guy, wasn't he?
Yeah. I should go back and try to watch. That was one of my favorites.
I really liked that show when it was out.
Phil Hartman
was in it. Yes.
Yep.
Fucking great. Man. And that guy what the hell's the name of the
film?
Kids in the Hall. Andy Dick was all right, but Kids in the Hall, the guy from Kids in the Hall who was the boss.
Oh, yeah, his name now.
Fucking fantastic. Like, Kids in the Hall was, I mean, they were hit or miss, but when they were hitting, I could appreciate it.
And I always liked the boss, too, the red stapler guy from Office Space.
Yeah.
He was like the owner of the radio station.
He's a great actor.
Yeah.
That was a good show. Tight. It had a good blend.
Dave Foley.
Yeah.
So if you haven't ever watched Talk Radio, it's a great series.
I wonder if it holds up, man. I know I loved
it. Yeah,
news
radio earlier?
It might not.
Yeah.
He used to laugh all the time at it.
But he apparently fell into that job. What?
Did someone say news radio earlier?
Talk radio.
Oh, yeah. It's talk radio.
Talk radio.
Right. I just wanted to.
I think I said news radio first. Yeah.
There we go. Clarifying. That's all.
I remember it being a fun show anyway.
No, he's great. I love his podcast. We've talked about that before. I should have put his face in the front of our thing talking about our favorite YouTubers. It's just good.
Two and a half hour to three hour. Yeah.
He's just so likable and so open and so like, here okay, man, this is my perspective. This is yours. Okay. And he'll debate in a very calm way. And
that's what I heard him talking about listening to him talking to some lady yesterday a little while, because I usually have him on in the background and stuff. But he was talking about just how he goes about talking to someone he might disagree with or whatever. And it is just the simple technique of absolutely listening to every bit
and trying
of
to
their
understand.
Side mm-hmm. completely. Yeah.
Yeah.
And you can tell he's actively trying to wrap his head around that angle, which so few people do. Like it's right. That's the way everybody.
You never
should.
See that on like, yeah, just a corporate, you know.
No.
Your standard
it's,
news
it's immediate. Like
yeah,
this is.
Oh, no. It's like we have 3 minutes. We have five talking heads. Go,
yeah, exactly.
And it is such
fuck
an
you.
Obnoxious format. I hope that format dies.
Right.
He has. Yeah, he has some pretty polarizing people
he
on
does.
There.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
That
they
he's
get
able
along.
To just talk to.
It's great.
And he wants to understand how they think, why they think the way they do, and doesn't really debate it so much as just listen.
Crazy how refreshing
that is.
I mean,
he has debated things.
Oh, surely. But the thing is also, like, he gets shit for having people on to the point where it's like, okay, if you've got, you know, a Nazi on, it's like, oh, yeah, you're supporting Nazis and giving them a platform. No, he's having a fucking conversation.
It's not how it works.
And that's the good thing. And that's what he keeps on preaching. It's just all about people having conversations and trying to see each other's points of view and understand each other better.
No.
That's the key, yeah. Why do you think the way you think? Can you explain to me why you think that way?
It's everything. Right. It's important.
And then Neves would follow up with, here's how you should think.
Yeah.
This is how you change, Neves.
After I figured out why they think. What they think.
Yeah. Right. Why do you sneeze the way you sneeze, Thick?
Yeah.
This is how you should sneeze.
Hey, don't act like I didn't change your life.
Hey, whenever I sneeze, I change my second one up because I know usually two are coming.
Yeah.
He saved your life, though.
Yeah. He did. I almost
there's
going to
be some situation where you're in a terrorist situation or there's
a
sleeping baby.
Exactly.
And they're not going to find you now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You're welcome.
For him.
Because I represent him in
this
case.
He did. Okay. He backed me on this.
Thank you.
On your change.
I heard when Neebs dies, he's having you killed as well to be buried by.
Everyone I know. All my friends are
going to help me pick 44.
We're all going to be euthanized and buried with Neebs. Great.
You guys are coming with me?
Well, it came full circle. We
I have
might
shoes
as well.
For everyone to wear,
if we
too.
All sign that contract where whichever one of us dies, the rest of us has to be put down to be buried. It's like, that'd be a really, really weird way to go about life.
Yeah, what a laugh. That'd make headlines.
You think I was picky about the way you live your life before?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, no shit.
Well, thank you guys.
Yeah.
This is the last of this type.
It's going to go through some changes.
Yeah, probably
it's
going to
go through puberty.
We'll see how it goes. But yeah, less comments from now on. More maybe news.
Other stuff.
Stuff. Yeah. Just stuff.
Fun information.
It'll be fun.
Yeah. Maybe an interview every now and then, maybe.
I would love to have interviews with Joe Rogan.
Oh, yeah. Joe's on my
invite him.
Speed dial thing.
He's on your speedometer.
That's right. The sticker.
Actually,
he's got no shirt on.
He's
I like
on
it.
Your wall in the form of a poster.
Mm-hmm. With no shirt on. Everything that I have of him, he has no shirt on.
Right.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Take it down, take it down. Take it down, take it down. Ba boop ba da dee da ba boop ba da dee da da doop da.